Okay, it's garden one right there. You got, we have five zucchinis down there. There's only three, well, three and a half are growing really good. One's going south on the far end, going out there with flowers on it. Already got some bees in there. My wife was going to pollinate them the way they show you how they can pollinate them. But there were bees inside already. And then we got two coming out going north here. Just got to the end of the garden here. It's about 8 feet, 8-9 feet long. And we got the torch sunflowers, which are those really big, big-leaved sunflowers. And I got titans on the other side. But I just want to show you painted pony beans right there. Right there. I just put this one out last night, or yesterday evening right there. Okay, Swiss chard in the corner. Can't really make it out with the sun in my face, but. Tomatillos, they look so-so. They look really like bug infested almost, like they're diseased, and then they seem to get healthy. See, now they're looking again, poor again. See, I mean, look at the leaves down there. I got a mix. See, then there's fresh green leaves up there, so I know the plant is healthy. It's just, I don't know, I have to spray these. Man, that would be a good time before the sun gets up. See, it's around 9 o'clock, about 9:30, maybe 10 o'clock even. I don't know exactly what time this morning, in the morning. It's Wednesday. But this is the sun in the morning, okay? At 8 o'clock, it's over there on the far west end of the number 3 garden. Then it slowly goes this way, and then it'll start opening up on number 1 here. And the tomatoes, which I should have done just the opposite. This should have been over on number 2 garden and number 2 over here, because peppers and tomatoes are going to go over there. And I think, you know, they'll get more than enough sun. They'll still get at least 12 hours of sun. But it'll be earlier sun over on this garden before it will be on this number 2 garden over there. And we didn't mean to break them up that way, but then we thought, well, why don't we just do this? We cut this plastic. It was going to be two big pieces of plastic like that back one back there, 50 by 24 or 25. I'm not sure exactly. And we're going to do the same thing here. And I thought, well, we'll split it up this way, which it will come out. It'll be nice. But again, the tomatoes and all that should probably be over here in the sun more. But right now we're going to tentatively put the... I have three eggplants growing yet. I'm in the house. But I wanted to put a row of tomatoes. I got one tomato down there. It was in the house. It was the healthiest one. So I brought this out about 4 days ago, 5 days ago maybe. And followed someone's suggestion on YouTube of putting that core on there so keep bugs off of it. Plus I sprayed it with Epsom salt and sugar, I believe it is. Helps tomatoes and peppers and roses. I wouldn't put it on anything else but peppers, tomatoes, and roses. So I got that, and then we were going to put like tomatoes back, and maybe another row of tomatoes, and then maybe those eggplants might go like in between this bean, and between that bean and that bean. But see, those should start going off to the string off to the left there, going north. We don't know yet. And there's a butterfly. See, the butterflies behind the wildflowers more. No, there's one in the garden. Yeah, go to the wildflowers, don't go to the ones. See, they're all going to the little flowers we get. See, that's like just grass that let go in the middle there. We're going to have to cut that perhaps this by this Saturday. If it doesn't rain, because it's been raining so much, that's why it hasn't been really kept down. Because this was all field. And I made it into a garden year before last, just cut it up with a tiller. Well, actually, no, it was back before my mom passed away in 2012. But since then, there's been so many hectic things going on. Haven't been able to just focus on doing this and doing that. Even this one, this has got more focus on it this year than it has in the last 10 years or 8 years that my wife and I have been together. So, but if everything, depending on how bad the country goes at the end of this year into next year, if we have that opportunity, this will be a really, really nicely set up garden. Because you're not supposed to keep your plants in the same spot anyway, so... If we put peppers over there, like we said before, two rows of peppers and then tomatoes and an eggplant, and then next year we'll do just the opposite. We'll have peppers and have like a row of peppers here and a row of peppers at the end over here, and then tomatoes over. And over here is where we put the zucchini and the tomatillos over on this side. And then basically all that stuff in the back there will be opposite size now. You'll have all your zucchini. Perhaps either in the middle or on the other side. We don't know how we're going to do that yet. But it'll be basically just the opposite. You know, all your beans over there will be on this side, or we might put the beans again right here and here where the watermelon and honeydew are at. So, like I said, if we don't go into a total third world dictatorship here by the end of 2015 into 2016, the garden next year will be like I was just saying. And like I said, this is a really good start. Of the 6 years that I've been doing this, and then my wife helping out, and now we're both doing it. This is by far the best. We've got the most out here. And it's just now going to be a question of getting out here and doing it, which, you know, again, I told her we'd get up in the morning, we'd come out here and we'd work on the garden. We got peppers we're going to plant today. They're like smaller than that right there. Let me zoom in if I can see it on this. Yeah, I can see that. I'm underneath the black crack on this viewfinder. They're all about 3/4 the size of that plant right there. It's a bunch of peppers, but we're going to put them over here where they'll be out of the wind. Last year or the year before, we did peppers up by the house, and they did really, really, really well. But there's different types of peppers too. But I told her we're going to leave the plastic down for the heat and all that. This is just 1 year. And then next year, maybe take the plastic up and use the same one for peppers again. Or maybe less peppers, more tomatoes. You know, I said you can always play with that, peppers and tomatoes. Have like half peppers, half tomatoes, but spread them, you know, like pepper, tomato, tomato, pepper, you know, just back and forth. We can get about 12 out here. So that's going to be done here in the next 15 minutes or 20 minutes. I got to get this excessive water off of the plastic. And then I'm going to make some X's, and then we're going to cut the plastic, and we're going to bring those peat planters and put them right down into the ground. Put a little bit. I got lime underneath here now. I chilled it up a little bit with a bow rake just. I didn't chill it. I just used a bow rake to rough up the ground. Put some lime down, then watered the lime down into the ground. Put the plastic back on top yesterday evening. And then come out here and put a hole on there with a hole for plants. Plugs, whatever, for bulbs, and then just put a little bit of 15-15-15 fertilizer down, just a little bit of soil to cover the fertilizer directly, and then the little peat planters, which is what's still in there. That's what's in all those beans, those painted pony beans, or the little cardboard-looking peat planters. We'll have those out here, and then I'll make a video just showing how the beans are placed out here. I mean, the peppers. This is about 18 feet by 5 feet, approximately. So we'll see what happens.